Hi, Manuel Suarez here, and today I have a very, very special episode for you. I decided to put together a video to talk about the five greatest lessons that I learned from my father over the years, over the last 11 years. He's been a hero of mine for a long time, but in the last 11 years, he became a business hero for me, and he became a mentor, and I got to understand his incredible genius. So let's get to it. This is my dad's five greatest lessons. So what are the things that we implemented along the way? Well, it all boils down to these five individual lessons that I learned over the last 11 years. Lesson number one, never say, I am spending. Never say, I am spending. I would come to him and I said, Dad, I spent $1,000 on this Facebook ad. And he would be like, right away, instantly, he would say, son, stop saying that. It's not you spent, it's you invested. So the lesson that he taught me is always say, I invested. We're talking about marketing here. He didn't like to use the word spending when we're talking about investing energy, which is also known as money, to capture the attention of people. Whether that was on television, on radio, newspapers, magazines, like he used to do before I stepped in, to investing advertising dollars on YouTube, on Facebook, on Instagram, on these digital platforms to capture attention of the millions of people that we capture every single day. Number two, it's about purpose, not money. When you are running a business in today's environment, you gotta have the right mindset for it. I always like to call that discovering what is your superpower. How can you make the world a better place with your content? How can you influence the lives of other people with your products and your services? If you don't have that clear, you're not gonna be able to succeed in this environment, and it's gonna become a challenge, and maybe, just maybe, you might get lucky enough that you can generate some money, whether you have an Amazon brand or an e-commerce shop. But at some point, that's going to die, and you're not building something that we like to call legacy. How you really change the world, how you really create an impact and build something that lasts for generation is with legacy, is with purpose. These are the things that go past a body. For example, my father, he passed away on February 25th of 2021. His message is being seen by more people now every single day that did not get a chance to meet him while he was alive. And he's being seen across all these platforms every single day, and he has a chance to help people with his incredible content that was his superpower. His ability to educate people on the metabolism and health, that was his number one superpower right there. It's not about money, it's about purpose. It's about legacy. Lesson number three. Nothing is more valuable than your team. And this is something that for me, once I really started winning in life and enjoying the game of life, was when I started building a team of people around me. A team of warriors that have a purpose, that they share a purpose with me. These people are with me because they want to make a difference in the world. I have 85 people in my company at AGM Marketing. We have 250 people in our company in Natural Slim. This company is driven by a purpose in Natural Slim that was created by my dad, in AGM Marketing that was created by me, and together we are conquering the world together. For me, there is nothing more valuable in the world than to have a team around you, people that you know you can count on, that they have your back no matter what. That's the most valuable thing, and that's what I, when you would ask my dad, what is his biggest accomplishment? This is on video everywhere. He would always tell you the same thing. My biggest accomplishment, even though I've helped so many people and I've done so much, is the team that I've been able to build around me. Number four, if an army is bleeding out, cut it and stop the bleeding. If you have an organization that has arms and legs and heads and all these parts, and one of them is failing, you gotta cut it out, close that wound, and keep going. How does that relate to the business world? So let's say you have a brand that is not doing that well, and you were romantic about it and you wanted to make it successful because you really believe in that brand. Let's say it's a beauty cream and you felt so good about it because that beauty cream is from the mountains and the Himalayas and it's so unique and so special, but people are not buying it. And it doesn't matter how good you get at marketing, people are not buying it. It's not showing the demand. It's not profitable. And then you have another brand, which is a beard balm and a beauty brand for men. And that's really rocking and rolling and you're doing really good with it and it's making money, it's making you profitable. But whenever you make money there, you give it to this other brand. And that other brand is bleeding you out. That romantic idea is making you suffer and it's gonna make your organization suffer. So my dad, one of the greatest things that he taught me along the way is like, look, son, if you have this brand that is not doing well, or if you have this product or service that is not doing well, it's bleeding out, you're not making money with it, you're spending more than what you're incoming, let's go ahead and cut that out and leave it alone and focus on the other ones that are doing well. If you have an arm that's bleeding out, you cut it out and you keep going forward. You do not sacrifice an entire body, an entire organization for one product or one service, no matter how romantic you are about that product. That's lesson number four. Final lesson, last but not least, this might be the most important strategy, the most important point that I learned from my dad over the last 11 years working by his side. And that is that a war is won with a strategy. It's not won with battles. It's not won with a campaign. It's won with a strategy. If you want to win in the game of business, you got to make sure that you approach that game correctly. And the first thing that you got to do before you do anything else is you got to map out a strategy. In our case, in Natural Slim, our strategy was simple. We put my dad in front of a camera. We had him talk his guts off every single day for years so we can acquire attention. And once we acquired attention, because he was really good at delivering content, we had a channel called Metabolismo TV. That channel is a powerhouse of a channel, acquiring the attention of millions of people every single month. And because we were effective at acquiring attention, we now have more customers than we can possibly serve because of all the attention that we captured. Our strategy was correct. So before you start investing in advertising, before you start opening up platforms, before you get into contracts with an agency, make sure that you have clarity. What is your strategy to dominate the game? If you need help with strategy, you can reach out to companies like us and we will be able to help you and provide you guidance in that area. If you guys are interested in talking to one of our marketing consultants, you can always reach out to our organization at 888-280-3339. And we will present to you a strategy for you to conquer the marketing world yourself. So these are the five lessons that I learned from my dad over the last 11 years working aggressively by his side, building our Natural Slim brand. I hope that that serves you some purpose, and I hope that you are ready to implement some of these strategies, some of this knowledge into your business and into your life every single day. Thanks for being here. I appreciate your time, and I will see you in the next episode.